Today is a tangible reality to us. We in JCI Botswana and in Botswana are excited to have managed to convince the world and convince JCI that indeed we can host them in Gaborone and in Botswana. May we give ourselves a round of applause. This conference is an irreplaceable opportunity for JCI Botswana to make impact in communities. The future of JCI Botswana will never be the same after this conference, because it is going to add value to the profile of our organization. Whenever we knock in the doors of our partners who are here tonight to tell them that JCI seeks to create a positive change in our communities, they will indeed understand the impact that we can make. And the understanding will be able They will be able to comprehend this understanding because they have seen you, members of JCI Africa and Middle East, members of JCI from across the globe, that you can travel to come far from your homes and the comfort of your homes to be with us here tonight. This is indeed a commendable thing. I would like to promise Botswana and JCI in general that we will not tire from trying to make our communities better. And we would like to even assure the government of Botswana, who have contributed immensely in assisting us to host the conference, that indeed we will ensure that we make our communities better. Because we are aware that the crisis of our communities is the crisis of inactive citizens. If our citizenry is not active, then we cannot achieve anything. If our people are not part of the solution of this world, then they are part of the problem. And we in JCI Botswana want to declare today that we are not going to be part of the problem, but we are going to be the solution. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to welcome you with one word from Henry Ford. He is a man who revolutionized the transport sector in the United States. When he said, a man who says, I can, and a man who says, I can't, they are both right. And I believe as JCI Botswana, when we said we can host Africa and Middle East in Botswana in Gaborone, we were right, because here you are, we are hosting you in Botswana. Ladies and gentlemen, mine is not much of a great speech or a long speech that will bore you that much, but it's to welcome you to Gaborone. I hope some of you have had days here. You have enjoyed the beautiful Gaborone and the beautiful Botswana. I remember when I was in Ghana, I told most of you that when you come to Botswana, you will enjoy space, you'll find land around, but I'm not promising to give you land, but you'll find space. And this is what most of you were telling me today, that, oh, there's a lot of space around here. And indeed, I think you realize that I was telling the truth. Ladies and gentlemen, let me, before I go down to my seat, thank the JCI members, our past leaders, who found it fit, because the idea to host this conference did not begin yesterday. It was a long-term vision that had people who believed that even if they are not there, there will be a generation that will be able to host this conference well. Today we sit in the shoulders, and proudly in the shoulders, of our past members who about 10 years ago began to try to convince JCI and the world and try to show us why JCI can host this conference. Thank you for your attention and welcome to Botswana. Thank you. Thank you.
The theme for the conference has been chosen as eradicating poverty through active citizenship. This is a relevant theme which I appreciate greatly. In fact, it resonates well with our government's national priorities. The conference is particularly important to me as a minister with portfolio responsibility for youth development, because it is unprecedented in the history of JCI activities in the Republic of Botswana. I am therefore going into historical records as the first minister of youth in Botswana to bring the JCI Africa and the Middle East Africa Conference since the first area conference for this was held in Casablanca, Morocco, in 1961. A very important year, 1961. In fact, and that's 52 years ago, in fact, I am informed that in Southern Africa, we are the second country to host this conference after the Republic of South Africa. To that end, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to the JCI World President and the JCI community for having believed in the young people of this beautiful country. They submitted a bid to host the conference, and Madam President, your organization gave them an opportunity to employ their ingenuity and other capacities to deliver this wonderful conference. And indeed, they have done that successfully. I am very proud of young people of this country. Ladies and gentlemen, the leadership of the Republic of Botswana has put the youth on a very high pedestal in the development agenda of this country. In this respect, the government has come up with a host of programs that has desired to empower young people. Among others, we have a program we refer to as the Youth Empowerment Scheme, and we also have a Youth Development Fund, which are very popular. We have what we call the Livestock Management and Infrastructure Development Program, and many others that seek to improve lives of many young people in this country. Furthermore, my ministry has provided financial support to JCI Botswana, amounting to close to half a million pula Botswana currency for the hosting of this conference, because we view it as of strategic significance to the development of youth in Botswana. We have even gone to the extent of giving them support during the initial stage of bidding to host this conference. Director of Ceremonies, we are now in the era of a globalized world where challenges are globalized and therefore calling for networking and globalized solutions. I have therefore noted with happiness that this conference has attracted more than 500 participants from Africa, America, Asia, Europe, and the Middle East. With this diversity of representation of young minds, I'm hopeful that through interchange of encouragement, support, and experience, the conference will stimulate the development of innovative ideas that should ultimately help your governments in addressing some of the challenges besieging the youth worldwide today. Conference participants, it is undeniably true that the youth worldwide face challenges relating to unemployment, poverty, diseases, especially HIV/AIDS, drug abuse, and many other social ills. There are also issues pertaining to international political relations and global economics, which affect your daily lives and that of the communities you live in. I therefore hope that you will take advantage of this conference to put your heads together and come up with better ideas of influencing change in your communities and in the process transforming this world. Ladies and gentlemen, I am also certain that this conference will forever remain imprinted in the hearts and minds of young people and Botswana at large. In this respect, I am informed that one of the conference requirements, JCI Botswana has entered into partnership with Zek Construction Company and the Haruni City Council to build a community daycare center. most importantly, the project represents the value of service to humanity in action, as espoused by JCI community. The government, through my ministry, highly appreciates this act of benevolence, and I also view the collaboration on the project as a public-private partnership model that could be emulated by other organizations. Lastly, I have also been informed that some of you conference participants deliberately arrived in Botswana a few days before the conference started, so that you could have an opportunity to look around and learn more about Botswana. That was good, and I hope the rest of the participants will delay their departure. So long as you do it within the limits of the immigration. We'll delay your departure back home and engage in similar adventure. I do not know what impression some of you have after being in this country for a few days. I can assure you that ours is a great country with great people. It is like an oasis of political stability and peace. A place where you feel at home as a foreigner, a home for the internationally acclaimed Okavango Delta, where flora and fauna are found in amazing abundance and topologies. Now, with these few remarks, I once again thank JCI World President and the rest of the JCI community for having honored our country with this conference. It means a lot to me as Minister responsible for youth empowerment and development. I also wish every conference participant an enjoyable stay in Botswana. Thank you very much for your attention.
Senators, distinguished guests, chers amis, membres de la GCI, sénateurs et invités, good evening, bonsoir, tout mélange. From our distinguished guest to skip the protocol, to tell you immediately that it's great to be back in Africa and Middle East. C'est magnifique être en Afrique et Moyen-Orient. Let me tell you that Botswana is the seventh country that I'm visiting this year in this area. And honestly, visiting your countries is an experience which is changing my life. Yes, that's true. And because I always say that we cannot build our future without knowing our history. Well, you know, historically, since the beginning, the presence of JCI in this continent was really brave. La présence de la JCI a toujours été très courageuse en ce continent. It's enough to say that the first national organization founded here was South Africa in 1957. You know better than me that in that time, in that country, there was the apartheid. But a group of brave young active citizens imported here an organization which has among its values the brotherhood of men and freedom. And I can't forget that exactly in the year in which I was born, 1976, in South Africa, JCI was the first organization of its kind to have multiracial membership. Once again, JCI dared to act. And also, thanks to this brave example of dare to act, in 1977, South Africa was the first national organization of this area to host a World Congress. I was just a child, therefore I didn't have the opportunity to attend that event that wrote such an important page in the history, not only of JCI. But I had the opportunity to attend the second one in Tunisia, where